Hey folks, David Stewart here. Don't forget, coming March 27th, the keys to prolific creativity to help you improve your creative output. What I'd like to talk about today is writing short fiction, short stories, specifically works that are in the 1,000 to 10,000 word range. And I pick that range because that's the meat of most stories that are published in literary magazines. If you're looking to get a story published, it's probably going to have a submission requirement of, say, 1,000 to 5,000 words. Probably not too much more than that, but I kind of want to expand the idea here. Once you get below 1,000 words, you start to enter into the flash fiction territory, which is a really different thing. And once you get above 10,000 words, you're in the novelette, novella category, and that tends to be a different approach as well. That's a much more fleshed out story where you can have a bigger plot and things like that. I'll explain as I get a little bit deeper into it. One to 10,000 word range, though, is really good. Now, a lot of people, when they're beginning this writing journey, they want to begin by writing short stories. And there is nothing wrong with that if, number one, you want to write short stories, and number two, you actually read short stories. And I bring this up because there's this advice that, I don't know, constantly gets circulated about, that the way to practice for your novel, which is super serious, is to write a bunch of short stories. Now, this advice is not completely bad, but a novel is a very different beast from a short story. There are some skills that will transfer. Some of your prose writing skills, obviously, that's going to be good practice for anything that you do in the fiction world. Maybe some practice writing dialogue will also help you to execute your novel well. But once you get to a full-length book, there's a whole lot more going on, and you have to really take a different approach to style and everything that you do when you're writing a long book. If you want to write short fiction, though, this is the other thing. You got to read short fiction, or you won't really have a good bead on what a short story is supposed to feel like and how it's supposed to operate. So if you want to write short stories, you need to be reading short stories. Luckily, here's what's great about short stories is they're short. You can read a bunch of them in a short amount of time, get the main idea, understand what's going on, be able to analyze them very quickly. It's a great area to get into as a reader and then to then get into as a writer as well. So if you're one of those people that you're really excited about writing a novel and you really don't read short fiction, you should read some short fiction anyway, but you're going to need to read some short fiction before you start trying to execute short fiction stories. Just as an example, the contrast between the two, there are H.P. Lovecraft stories that have no dialogue. You're not really going to write a 100,000 word book without dialogue. That's going to be pretty tough. But that stylistic difference is available in short fiction because you're only reading 1 to 5,000 words usually, and not having dialogue for that amount of time, having it be a complete narration with no actual interaction between other characters, like, say, I mentioned H.P. Lovecraft, The Nameless City is an example. So it could be something like that. That's a very different approach to writing a story than writing a full-length novel. You will get some practice with prose, but even then, if you're writing short fiction, the prose needs to be more functional and in many ways more compact. If you read the old stories of Robert E. Howard, he was really excellent at communicating a large amount of setting information in particular in a short amount of time with his prose. So if you want to be able to do that well, like let's say you want to write fantasy short stories, you need to be reading some Robert E. Howard. You need to be reading some H.P. Lovecraft in particular. And of course, if you're writing horror short stories, I think Stephen King's are some of the best. Here's the thing about writing short fiction. Unlike writing a novel where you have a long, complicated plot and then multiple subplots, when you're writing short fiction, you pretty much want to just go with one plot. So that's my first piece of advice for writing short fiction, is that you don't have subplots. The truth about the length of story and how long a story feels has to do with how many different threads there are, how many different layers of plot, how many different subplots you're actually trying to get involved with the story. If there's just one plot, then the story can be very, very compact and very, very interesting if you make that one plot interesting in and of itself. When I say plot, I mean an event sequence. So one event sequence where you have a conflict or you have a goal, and then you go through a series of obstacles and events that either get you closer to your goal, move you further away from your goal until you reach the end. Now, if you look at a plot as just that, you can put as many of those events in or as few of those events in as you need to in order to tell the story that you want to tell in the appropriate length. So if you want to have a really short story, you set up a goal, and then you have maybe one obstacle, and then the character finds a way around that obstacle, and then the story's done. And you've written a complete story with a plot and characters and a setting, and you can do it in a really short amount of time. The goal of something like flash fiction, which is usually below 1,000 words, is to try to do that really in as short amount of space as possible. That's not really the goal of short stories in general. It's really to tell a satisfying story within, you know, that more limited time frame that still has enough breath and life to it that it feels like something complete. So I really would, first recommendation is that you keep it single plot and keep the event sequence fairly short so you can get it packed in that amount of time. The other piece of advice is to limit the amount of characters. You can have 1 to 2 characters with dialogue, and you can write a very efficient short story that fleshes out those characters very well. I mentioned Robert E. Howard. Robert E. Howard has stories where there's really only 2 or 3 characters talking in the entire story. And because you are kind of shoveling off to the side any other auxiliary characters, their opinions, and their effect on the plot, because every time you bring in a character, it should have some sort of effect on the story. If you can keep it down to just 2 characters or even 1 character, then you have a lot better control over how long the story needs to be. So 1 character by himself, you can execute a story really quickly, like with H.P. Lovecraft would often do this. And if you have 2 or 3 characters, you can do really, really effective work like Robert E. Howard or even newer authors like Stephen King would do with the shorter fiction. And once you start adding in more characters, the length of the book is gonna grow. And one of the things that happens, the reason you have lots of characters, like you may have a main character, you may have his best friend, but you may have a love interest. That love interest creates a second plot, creates a B story. So you want to keep that love interest out of short stories, unless that's the A story. If it's a love story as the main story, then yes, you can keep it in there. So limit the plots, only 1 plot, limit the number of events, limit the number of characters, and you're going to be able to keep that story fairly short. The next thing is to be very efficient with describing your story. In short stories, this is the area where you really want to convey information quickly and efficiently to the reader because you only have a certain amount of space to do it. And you also want the reader to have all of the pieces to the puzzle set up ahead of time. You want them to have all the chess pieces on the board for whatever plot you're going to tell as quickly as possible so that their expectations are set up really quickly, their projections of what's going to happen in the story will happen very quickly, and then you're able to play with those in a short amount of space with the plot. This means that your introduction, if you're writing a novel, you might start with a battle or something like that. A short story, probably not the best idea to start in that specific way unless the entire story takes place in that one battle. What you actually want to start with is some kind of introduction that will quickly communicate to the reader exactly who is involved, what their position is, what their goals are. Within the first couple paragraphs, you need to be establishing the main character and the main goal of the plot, the outcome that character wants to achieve and that they're going to be trying to achieve. You really want to do that with a novel too. You want the first page for the reader to have an idea of what the main conflict actually is. But you got to do this very quickly in a short story. You can't tickle the reader necessarily with attention-grabbing things. You already have their attention, really. But what you really want to do is get them quickly to the point where they're like, I want to see what happens. So you got to do that very, very quickly. So those are my big 3 tips for that. Keep single plot, limited number of events, limited character cast, probably 2 characters, maybe 3 if that 3rd character is like an antagonist or really disturbs the plot somehow for the other 2. And you like to have 2 characters on board, by the way, so they can have conversations. So the readers really like dialogue. You can write, if you have 1 character, obviously you can just avoid dialogue, but it's really nice to have dialogue. Even when I wrote Voices of the Void, here it is. There's really only, there's 2 characters in it, one of which can speak, but there's still some dialogue. There's a part where the main character is talking to a robot. Otherwise, he's talking to a girl who can't speak due to a brain injury affecting her ability to physically make sounds with her mouth and vocal cords. So in this sort of book, because it's one plot, I was able to keep it pretty short. It's only about like 20-something thousand words. So it's in the novella category, really. And it's pretty short, but I cut out, there's no B story, really, and there's no C story, really. And what we get instead is one character's perspective blasting through a bunch of event sequences that are there to prevent create obstacles for what he's doing, what he's trying to find out, and then to get him out of the plot and to resolve everything. So you can write a lot of action in a short amount of space if you keep that cast limited. There's really only two characters in Voices of the Void. It's pretty simple to do that. And then, of course, plot sequence, single plot. And as far as communicating the setting, I do that indirectly at the beginning, but it's right away you know exactly where you are and what's going on. And I do that basically on the first page. And I think that's why a lot of people like this book, is it gets you into the story really quickly, and it doesn't clog things up with a bunch of alternative plots or love stories or anything like that. It just kind of goes straight through it. So those are my tips for writing short fiction. And you can actually apply these to longer things like novellas, like I mentioned. And you can even apply these to flash fiction, though I think once you get below 1,000 words, you're losing a lot of capacity to have flavor to your story. So thanks so much for watching. Don't forget to like, comment down below with what you think and any suggestions for short fiction authors that you like or literary magazines that you like to read. That's a great place to access these short stories. The huge variety if you buy a literary magazine, and you can like half the stories and feel like you still enjoy reading it. These things have kind of gone by the wayside as of late, but it's still worth checking out short fiction because it's a very efficient way to have a lot of entertainment. So thanks so much, and I will see you all next time. Oh, don't forget, yes, Keys to Prolific Creativity. Go ahead and pre-order it. It's only $2.99 for the pre-order. I will have a physical edition releasing shortly before the ebook and audiobook to follow. So thanks so much, and I'll see you next time.